the judiciary.
So here all the courts at different levels in a country put together are called the judiciary. So here the Indian judiciary consists of a Supreme Court for the entire nation, high courts in the states, district courts and the courts at the local level. So here India has an integrated judiciary, which means the Supreme Court controls the judicial administration in the country. Its decision are binding on all other courts of the country, and it can take up any dispute between citizens of the country and between citizens and government, between two or more state governments, and between governments at the union and state level.
Powers of judiciary. The judiciary in India is one of the most powerful in the world. So here it is one of the most powerful in the world. The Supreme Court and the High Court, they have the power to interpret the constitution of the country. So here they can change the constitution of the country. They can determine the constitutional validity of any legislation or action of the executive in the country. So here they can determine the validity of any legislation or action of the executive in the country when it is challenged before them. This is known as the judicial review. The Supreme Court of India, it has also ruled that the core or basic principle of the constitution cannot be changed by the parliament. So here the Supreme Court of India, it has also ruled that the core or basic principles, it cannot be changed by the parliament. The powers and independence of the Indian judiciary allow it to act as the guardian of the functional rights. And anyone can approach the courts if public interest is hurt by the actions of the government. So here anybody can approach the court if public interest is hurt by the actions of the government. This is called public interest litigation.